everyone, and welcome to another edition of In the Know, the jazzy radio magazine show that keeps you in the know about entertainment, health, food, fashion, lifestyles, and community affairs. I am your host, Denise Barnes, right here with you on Radio Free Nashville, 103.7 and 107.1 FM. And you can stream us, you can hear us worldwide all over 24 hours a day at radiofreenashville.com. So now, sit back, relax, and get rejuvenated right here on In the Know Radio Magazine Show. At this time, we are opening the pages of the magazine to our entertainment segment. Lionel Richie and Mariah Carey announced rescheduled tour dates. Now, Lionel Richie announced rescheduled dates on Thursday for his All the Hits tour. The Trek, which features special guest Mariah Carey, will now begin July 18th in Paso Robles, California, and conclude September 5th in Seattle. Lionel Richie states, looking forward to getting back on the stage to perform for you all. And he also wrote this in a statement and announced in December, the tour was originally slated to begin March 15th in Baltimore and conclude May 27th in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. But Mariah Carey actually underwent a knee procedure that forced her and Richie to postpone the dates. While not at all the original shows were able to be rescheduled, not all of them were, we did our best, says Richie. And tickets for the rescheduled dates will be honored and refunds are available at the point of purchase. So again, Lionel Richie and Mariah Carey has announced rescheduled tour dates. So wishing Lionel a very, very speedy recovery. So I hope again that you all have been having a wonderful week. Make sure that you follow me on Twitter to continue to stay in the know, and that handle there is ITK Radio Mag Show. And on Facebook, that public figure page is In the Know Radio Magazine Show. So much is going on, especially in the entertainment world. I am looking here. There is so much magical bracket game. I'm just scrolling here to give you more entertainment news about everything that is going on. We just talked about Lionel Richie and Mariah. They were scheduled to appear here in Nashville, Tennessee. But again, he has announced some tour dates changes due to a surgery that, you know, Lionel Richie did have. Buffy the Vampire Slayer, you know, the 20th anniversary. And if you've never watched the show, you must. It is a must to watch Buffy the Vampire Slayer again. It's celebrating the 20th anniversary with the sweet new merch. Members of the Scooby gang preparing to celebrate Buffy the Vampire Slayer's 20th anniversary now have something to make the festivities a little extra special. With Sunnydale's favorite hero set to hit a big milestone, fans can expect a range of official anniversary merchandise. And look at this merchandise. If you could see it, Buffy the Vampire Slayer, Big Bads and Monsters adult coloring book. Relive more of your favorite Buffy scenes as you color in this upcoming adult coloring book, which you can see in exclusive illustrations of some of the biggest shows, bads, including the Master, Drusilla, Angelus, and Spike. So again, Buffy the Vampire Slayer, 20th anniversary. So there you are, just a little information to start the show during the entertainment segment. We are excited. You know why? Because it's our 20th year, so we are seniors, and that means we're having a senior prom. Join us at Radio Free Nashville's Birthday Bash Senior Prom, Sunday, April the 2nd, from 1 to 4 p.m. at Yazoo Brew. It'll be better than the prom you had in high school. Believe me, we've got music from Easy Roscoe, Screaming Names, MD, and Cobalt Blue, and also lots of goodies and fun, including Nothing Bundt Cake, Mike's Ice Cream, a dance contest, great prizes, and delicious Yazoo Brew. Guess what? Four are included with your ticket purchase. Get this, four Yazoo Brew included with your ticket purchase. Now, advanced tickets are on sale now, and they're available. Contact myself, contact myself again. Social media, Facebook, In the Know Radio Magazine Show. My handle on Twitter is ITK Radio Mag Show. Contact us. And by the way, we will be crowning a prom king and queen. If you want to vie for the crown, dress to impress. Again, Radio Free. It's our 12th year, and it's our senior prom. You're listening to another edition of In the Know, the Jazzy Radio Magazine Show. And when we return, more of the show. We'll be right back with you.
Jazz. Hip-hop. And R&B. It's all the same music. Finally, somebody got it. It's us. It's Unwrapped, Volume 2. I'm Frank Ski, and I'm out.
Hi, I'm Jonathan. I'm a big supporter of Radio Free Nashville. Tune in daily at 2 p.m. for Democracy Now!, the national daily independent award-winning news program hosted by journalist Amy Goodman and Juan Gonzalez. Democracy Now! Provides access to people and perspectives rarely heard in the U.S. corporate-sponsored media, including independent and international journalists. Ordinary people from around the world who are directly affected by U.S. foreign policy, grassroots leaders and peace activists, artists, academics, and independent analysts. Hear the real debate weekdays at 2 on Democracy Now!, right here on Radio Free Nashville.
Nashville, you're listening to WRF Fan Radio Free Nashville. This is Will with Phenomenal Advice. Check me out every Thursday evening from 5 o'clock to 6 o'clock as I give you the latest health and fitness pointers and tips to transfer your life into a healthy one. Everyone take care and peace.
I don't eat no meat, no dairy, no sweets. Only ripe vegetables, fresh fruit and whole wheat. I'm from the old school. My household smell like soul food, bruh. Curry falafel, barbecue tofu.
Hey, no all fish y'all blues children out there. Y'all tune in to Have Blues Will Travel, Thursday nights 8 to 9 on Radio Free Nashville. Gonna give you that good down-home blues, y'all.
Like a wide range of music? Then tune in to the Haggard and Haggard Radio Hour, a fixture on Radio Free Nashville since 2008. Host Steve Haggard plays an eclectic mix of music of many styles and many eras. Americana, blues, rock, folk, rockabilly, old standards, indie music, songs in other languages, plus a lot of meaningless less banter. The Haggard and Haggard Radio Hour, Tuesdays at 4 on Radio Free Nashville.
Kenny Lattimore, who's being honored today. So my question to you is, you know, how do you keep your career? You know, you've been around and you've had hits decades going on, and you know, so many people have come and gone. How do you do it?
You know what, I think it's being authentic to yourself, and really God is that piece that draws people to whatever they're drawn to. I think there's so many things that we are not in control of,
right?
But if you can just be consistent with what you do, I think I've just tried to be consistent in the lyrics, the messages, the quality of the production, and I think people just feel it.
Right.
So that whether I'm putting something out on Columbia, on a big, huge label,
right,
or like I did E1 with my last CD, which
was great. Oh,
thank you so much.
Great.
I tried to give it the quality. I appreciate
it. It was great.
I appreciate that. Hey, there it is.
So, now, you've always been a sharp dresser, but look.
Thank you.
See, I'm copying off of him. Look, we got lapel pins and stuff. Gentlemen, this is what you're supposed to look like when you come outside.
I love it.
Pants pulled up, clean, fitted, and everything. We're going to follow Kenny Lattimore because you're going to see him a little bit more than you're going to see me.
Oh,
so he's going to be the standard for male fashion. So, thank you so much. Okay, look at his face. This is Miss California 2017 India. You're beautiful.
Oh, thank you so much. That's so sweet.
Thank you. So tell us a little something about yourself.
Yeah, so I am, as he said, the new Miss California USA, and I was just crowned this past Sunday.
Congratulations.
So this is my first event here with Brotherhood Crusade, so I'm so excited to be here tonight. Okay. Yeah.
What's your platform?
My platform, so something I'm really passionate about is an organization called the Samburo Project, which works to provide clean and safe drinking water to Kenyan communities. You know, I know that's something very close to our hearts here in California as we're experiencing a drought, but imagine not even having clean drinking water to drink or provide for your family. So that's something I hope to continue on working with that organization throughout the year.
This is Social Connection TV, and we are here with television and entertainment legend, Miss Allie Mills. How are
you? I'm so fantastically happy to be here today.
And you're starring on The Bold and the Beautiful.
I am.
And how long have you been on The Bold and Beautiful?
10 years.
Wow.
I went in to do 10 days 10 years ago.
Wow.
Somebody just said that to me. I went, don't tell me it's been 10 years. But it has. And I'm not quite as mentally ill as I was.
Right.
But I'm still a little unbalanced,
okay.
A little weird.
Now, I'm sure all my viewers, they recognize your face. Can you give a condensed list of some of your credits?
I think most people, if they saw it, would know me from a show I did for 7 years called The Wonder Years. I played the mom on a show that took place in the 60s, but I did 11 other TV series. That one lasted the longest. And then I do now a lot of Hallmark movies, you know, those little Christmas puppy,
yes,
kind of movies. And then the soap and... I've been around a long time.
You gotta put some respect on her name. How can we follow you?
I mean, like,
on social media.
I don't have a social media.
Okay, well, if you want to see Miss Mills, you got
to follow. Do you know what I mean? It's like, I want to go home and be with my family. And so I have a flip phone.
Oh, wow.
I don't even have an iPhone.
If you want to follow Allie Mills, watch The Bold and the Beautiful.
That's right. That's
Thank
a good
you
one.
So
it's
much.
So nice to meet
Same
you.
Same here. Oh my God, here comes Jack A. I have been waiting to meet this woman since the 1980s. I know you're working like crazy, but can you tell the viewers exactly what you're doing?
A couple of movies, A Husband for Christmas, Cupid's Proxy, they all come out on Hallmark. I've become a Hallmark woman now.
That's amazing.
Yeah, isn't it?
That's amazing.
And I'm doing a lot of shows, Baby Daddy, you know, a lot of different shows that people don't watch, The Thundermans. I'm on a lot of different shows, thank God, praise God. And I'm doing a play with Vivica Fox. It's called Mama's Baby Boy, and we're coming to L.A.
I'm here with Emmy winner, Loretta Devine. How are you, Ms. Devine?
I'm very good, thank you.
You look amazing.
Thank you, I appreciate that.
Now, I wonder, are the Carmichaels coming back on?
Yes, we start back working in January.
Okay, great, and what else can we expect from you?
So lucky. They picked up Doc McStuffin, so that's coming back, and I have a new movie coming out with Marlon Wayans called Naked. It's going straight to Netflix, so I'm excited about that.
Great, and how can we follow you?
Adlo Diva Devine.
Okay. Thank you so much for taking a moment this week, though.
Yes, nice to talk to you. You look fabulous.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank
Bye-bye.
And I'm here with the star of Rosewood, Gabrielle Dennis. Gabrielle, how you doing? Now you are tearing it up in Rosewood.
Yes.
You know, you're one of the reasons I watch.
Oh, thank you.
You do. I love you on that show.
Thank you so much.
Now, what can we expect from when the winter finale's over, when it comes back?
You know what? We're in the middle of shooting season two now. So it's interesting to see now that my characters, she stopped working at the lab. She's pursuing her music career,
okay,
singing, recording music. And then, like, she's torn between that lifestyle as well as working in the lab with her brother and the family business. So that dynamics, whether or not she's going to get back with her fiance that broke up with her,
okay,
who left her standing there in her dress, like,
right,
girl, really?
But you look bad.
Thank you. I was like, but you could have made this decision prior to me paying for this dress. Like, who does that? So, but it's been a lot of fun, and I'm having a blast working on the show, and I couldn't be happier to be involved with, you know, the likes of Morris Chestnut and Lorraine Toussaint, who,
right,
are vets in the game. So I'm having an amazing time.
Great. So how can our viewers follow you?
You can follow me on Instagram at Gabrielle_Dennis, and then I'm on Twitter at Gabrielle Dennis.
I'm here with the amazing Anthony Hamilton.
Uh-huh.
How you doing?
I'm good. I'm blessed, brother, to be a part.
And we are back again, everyone. I want to say thanks for tuning in to another edition of In the Know, the Jazzy Radio Magazine show right here on Radio Free Nashville. And remember, this is the show that keeps you in the know about entertainment, health, food, fashion, lifestyles, and community affairs. And we are back. I hope you enjoyed my entertainment reporter on the West Coast, Las Vegas. That's Stephen Littles. And he was just out there interviewing so many fabulous celebrities. Kenny Lattimore, I hope you enjoyed that. Also, Miss California, Allie Mills from The Bold and the Beautiful, Jack Hay. I love me some Sandra from 227. Again, Jack Hay, Loretta Devine, the beautiful, magnificently talented Loretta Devine from the Carmichaels, talking about her upcoming shows and movies that she's working on. Gabrielle Dennis from Rosewood and Anthony Hamilton. So again, Stephen Littles, thank you so much. Doing that great entertainment reporting all the way on the West Coast. Las Vegas, thanks again so much. So at this time, we're going to turn the pages of the magazine to our health segment. The powerful ways divorce can impact your health. The stress of a marital breakup can take a serious toll on both physical and mental well-being. Love is dead. That was the collective sigh from the internet when Brangelina announced their split not long ago. We don't know much about why the famous couple decided to end their 12-year relationship and 2-year marriage. This decision was made for the health of the family. This is what Jolie released. But what we do know is that divorce can be a brutal process, affecting your mental and physical well-being for years and years to come. You know, even when the decision is the best one for all involved. Negative emotions that accompany divorce, like sadness, anxiety, worry, and feeling overwhelmed, are a type of stress for the body. This from Chicago-based psychologist and physical therapist Elizabeth Lombardo. The events leading to the breakup and the divorce proceedings themselves can drag on, creating quote-unquote chronic stress that adversely affects every single organ and system in your body. For one, divorce can take a serious toll on your heart. No big surprise there now. A 2015 study published in the journal Circulation, Cardiovascular Quality and Outcomes. Now, this found that women who had been through a marital breakup were 24% more likely to have a heart attack. And women who had experienced more than one divorce had a 77% increased risk. Other research from Johns Hopkins Bloomberg School of Public Health found that people who live through a divorce develop more chronic conditions such as heart disease and diabetes, and mobility issues like difficulty climbing stairs down the road. Then there's the damage divorce, which can do your psychological well-being, what it can actually do to your psychological well-being. Now, research from the Journal of Applied Social Psychology found that ongoing conflict with an ex-spouse, say if you're co-parenting, places a real burden on mental health. And another study found that people with a history of depression are more likely to relapse if they go through a divorce. Stress wreaks such havoc for many reasons. It boosts blood pressure and kicks the immune system's normal inflammatory response into overdrive. That excess inflammation can lead to everything from a cold to autoimmune disorders. Feeling frazzled also makes it harder for you to stick with your healthy habits. Now, when you're stressed, you're not reaching for a fresh garden salad. The wine bottle is calling for you in the kitchen. You're skipping sleep, and you may gain or lose weight. Again, this is from Dr. Lombardo. She says you may also ignore any symptoms that pop up and skip appointments with your doctor. But there are things that you can do to stay well through this painful experience. And Dr. Lombardo says the key is to make time for self-care. When your stress level is at 7 out of 10 or higher, you don't think or act rationally. So aim to keep your stress level at a 6 or lower, which will enable you to interact with your ex more productively and make the best decisions for your life ahead. Now, Dr. Lombardo goes on to say, get yourself out of the red zone in a healthy, helpful way. Walk with a friend, dance to your favorite songs, Go to yoga. No matter how crazy things get, you need to allow your body this time to decompress and return to a normal-ish state. And when you periodically make an effort to relieve some of the stress, you'll be on a more even keel. And that can help you make it through to the other side with your physical and mental health intact. So I hope this information has been helpful to someone out there. Again, during the health segment, remember the powerful ways divorce can impact your health, because the stress of a marital breakup can take a serious toll on both physical and mental well-being. And when we return, we have a special guest, Leah Maria, and she's going to talk to us about stress, anxiety, and some PTSD issues during the lifestyle segment. But hang in there. You are listening to another edition of In the Know, the Jazzy Radio Magazine Show, and we will be right back with you.
Always there when you called, always on time. Gave you my baby.
Always there when you call, but
Everyone, we are back again. You are listening to another edition of In the Know, the jazzy radio magazine show that keeps you in the know about entertainment, health, food, fashion, lifestyles, and community affairs. And at this time, we are turning the pages in the magazine to our lifestyle segment, when people suffer from different mental illnesses. Now, they often suffer alone. Mental illness can be stress, PTSD, anxiety, even memory loss, as well as an array of others. Now, in comes Leah Marie, who suffered a near-death experience, and she's my guest today. Leah, thank you so much. How are you?
I'm doing well. How are you, Denise?
I'm doing well. Again, thanks for joining me, because this information is vital, and I want to begin our conversation with this question. As mentioned, Leah, you experienced a near-death episode, which led to natural ways of managing pain and PTSD, that is. Share with us ways that you teach your clients through meditation.
Well, you know, I think that it's important that everyone knows that our brains are required to go through different cycles, mm-hmm, every day in a 24-hour period in order to maintain optimal health and, you know, keep stress low. When we don't get enough sleep, when we don't go through these cycles that our brain requires, we really are depriving ourselves of being in a healthy state. And you end up tying more into the emotional part of your brain, which is called the amygdala.
Yes.
And if you're always in emotion, then you're not always thinking clearly about every situation. And, you know, you might perceive some situations that if you had enough rest, if you had, you know, your body was, like, operating totally correctly, you wouldn't be reacting in a negative way to some certain situations than if you were rested. So it's important that everybody understands that, you know, we're not machines. And mm-hmm. I think we in this culture feel that it's something that we have to do every day.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think the world of technology has brought so much to our, you know, our existence in so many ways, but it also hasn't allowed us to have the proper downtime that is kind of required for our overall well-being.
Wow.
Yeah. And it is, like I heard you mention memory loss, and that's a big area that I work with. I work with a lot of people that have memory loss, early stage dementia,
mm-hmm.
right through Alzheimer's and other types of dementias as well. So, you know, they're saying that a lot of those diseases are, you know, contributed to because of not enough rest,
mm-hmm.
Too much stress.
Yeah.
So... you know, that's kind of the things that I share to the healthcare field currently is the holistic stress reduction
mm-hmm.
that can help improve these conditions. So,
and Leah, now you mentioned briefly regarding Alzheimer's and dementia. Talk just a few moments about Alzheimer's and what it really means. What happens to the individual's brain during this time?
Yeah, so... just a side note, my grandfather passed in the 80s from Alzheimer's.
I'm
and
sorry
so that's
to hear
why
that.
I'm yeah. Well, you know, it really it brought about my interest level in this condition, and I think that it's so important that we know early on
mm-hmm.
that Alzheimer's can start as early in the brain as 45 years old.
Wow.
So it's important to take care of your brain health. And that's one thing that I'm kind of getting at is when you're constantly bombarded, when you're not allowing yourself to take the downtime that's required, and I want to talk about that in a moment,
sure.
what I mean by the downtime, then you're missing out on optimal health for your brain,
mm-hmm.
which could result later on in Alzheimer's. The statistics are that 1 in 4 people over 65 have Alzheimer's, and 1 in 2 people over 85 have Alzheimer's.
Wow.
And it's pretty staggering. Yes.
Yes, it is. It really is. And Leah, besides meditation styles, you also teach emotional freedom technique and practical yoga. How are you able to bring a higher level of consciousness and awareness to individuals?
Well, you know, yoga is a very ancient practice, and meditation goes hand in hand with yoga.
Mm-hmm.
Meditation is when you're doing yoga, you're preparing for the ultimate spiritual experience, the ultimate meditation, and so you're releasing different energies through the poses of yoga. And once you go through all of the poses and reach a point in the practice where you're ready for your ultimate meditation, that's when you settle down. And you work on the brain, you know, and you work on the exercise of the brain.
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of, it's an ancient practice that there's so much scientific evidence now stating that it's so appropriate for us as human beings to go through these poses and experience this and then ultimately get into the brainwave, which is called the alpha brainwave state that allows us to meditate. And a lot of people are kind of, you know, they feel frustrated or negative about getting, you know, settled down and putting some time into that. If they only knew how important it was for your health,
mm-hmm.
they would probably be more app.
Exactly. Yes.
And it's not even very long. Like, it's only 10 minutes to 26 minutes a day is what it's been proven to have the ultimate brain health.
Wow.
So if you meditate every day for 10 to 12 minutes, I mean, excuse me, 12 minutes to 27 minutes a day, I think is the exact numbers,
mm-hmm.
You actually start to grow gray brain matter in the areas for learning, language, and compassion.
Wow.
And these, interestingly enough, the correlation between the diseases that happen in the brain that cause memory loss, those are usually typically the first areas of the brain to deteriorate.
Okay.
When you're going into that memory loss and early stage dementia process. So, you know, I think it's really important that we look at not only going to the gym to exercise our bodies, but incorporating that level of meditation into your day. They're saying that after 8 weeks, you can actually start seeing the changes in MRI brain scans of this growth of gray brain matter.
All right, so they're
pretty fascinating.
They're making great strides on that, and it is definitely absolutely needed. Again, listeners, we're speaking with Leah Maria, and she's a certified holistic life and stress management coach. She also teaches life-enriching techniques such as various meditation styles, emotional freedom techniques, and other mindfulness approaches to improving your life. Leah, what are some other natural ways that we can utilize to reduce stress?
Yeah, so, you know, we often talk about loving ourselves,
mm-hmm.
and I don't know that we, you know, kind of take the practices into consideration when you're doing that. And Ayurveda has a wonderful Ayurvedic practices, establishing a daily routine of that is really something you can do to include that self-love, self-care into your daily practice. There's, you know, self-massage, there's taking care of your senses, and establishing a routine that you're committed to every day.
Yes.
A typical Ayurvedic practice for daily routine is, you know, drinking maybe some tea with lemon,
yes.
and then doing the neti pot. I don't know if you've ever heard of the neti pot.
Where you, yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's cleansing your sense of smell.
Mm-hmm.
They recommend rose water for your eyes, a tongue scraper to get rid of the bacteria on your tongue,
uh-huh.
and oil pulling, which is, you know, you take coconut oil and swish it around in your mouth. And
okay.
all of these things are really, you know, taking the time with a mindfulness practice, a mindfulness approach of caring for yourself in a physical way. And then, as I said, the yoga gets rid of the extra energy that's in your body. The poses are just, they're created to help certain energies released from your body.
Mm-hmm.
And the meditation is really just the ultimate practice. And, you know, you mentioned my near-death experience
yes.
early on in
mm-hmm.
this conversation,
mm-hmm.
and I'd like to touch upon that.
Yes,
because,
please.
Yeah, so when I had my near-death experience, I actually was riding a horse that I bought this horse, and she was an ex-racetrack horse that had been injured, and I decided I wanted to try this. I was 30 years old,
okay.
and I'd ridden my whole life, but this particular horse, I didn't realize the magnitude of where she was at in her mindset. She, when I had purchased her, I guess she had been on some painkillers and stuff because her personality was completely different than mm-hmm. it was several months later when she healed. She, you know, I helped her heal her injury, and I took her out. I'd been riding her in a closed ring. I took her out into an open field,
mm-hmm.
and when I got her out there, she just went crazy.
Wow.
And,
oh, my goodness.
Yeah. Yeah, so she reared up, and I did a technical error by pulling on the reins, and we both went over backwards,
oh.
and she landed on top of me.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, so my father was there, and fortunately, he had had CPR courses
okay.
like 30 years before, and so any of you that have had CPR courses, certification course, and haven't used it, it will probably kick in when needed. So
that's right. That's good. Your
yeah,
father was there. That was such a blessing. Yes.
Yeah, I always say he gave me life twice.
Yes, absolutely.
I'm blessed in that way. So he resuscitated me because my heart had stopped. I'd stopped breathing and all of that. And when I came to, you know, it was pretty significant for me. I witnessed my father in a state of grief. He thought I had passed. He was crying. And, you know, I heard him saying, "She's gone, she's gone." Oh. And I'm, like, grabbing his arm saying, "Dad, who's gone?"
Oh, no.
And he didn't even, like, it didn't even register with him because he was so, like, he was so, you know, in a state of grief
of
and
course,
shock himself.
Yes.
Yeah. And so I, you know, was patting him on the arm saying, "Who's gone, Dad?" You know, and then I realized, oh, he's talking about me.
Wow.
You know? Yeah. So, he recovered, and I recovered as well. It did take a long time to recover from myself. But I always share the magnitude of what happened to me while I was, you know, out of body, or however you want to say it. For me, I am a very feeling person. I always feel other people's energy. I feel things. That's my greatest sensing attribute for the way I am. But when I was out, I actually felt this intense love that, you know, I can't even explain. It's not of this earth. But I know that it was just totally an unbelievable experience, and I couldn't talk about it for a very long time.
Yes.
Many years I didn't speak of it.
Wow.
So when I was out of the body, I actually experienced the contrast of what the pain I was feeling in my, you know, earthly body versus what was happening over in, you know, the other consciousness, I like to say, the love consciousness. And when I came back into my body, I can remember it was almost like I was being placed back in from the right side.
Wow.
And the magnitude of the pain that I felt from the love that I felt was, it was just too obvious to me. And, as I said, it was really hard to even acknowledge that for a very long time. But,
I am amazed. I'm amazed. I'm speechless at your story. Listeners, again, Leah Marie was directed to her spiritual path after having a near-death and out-of-body experience in 2001, as she just mentioned. And, of course, such a blessing that her father was there to resuscitate. Leah, this is just an amazing, amazing story that you have shared, your out-of-body experience. It's just eye-opening.
It was amazing. It was. And, you know, I kept it to myself for a long time, but I feel that humanity is becoming more and more open.
Mm-hmm.
And I started speaking about this stuff back in about 10 years ago in the medical field. And speaking at different hospitals, I was asked to speak to different groups of people that were maybe suffering depression and that sort of thing. That maybe had been diagnosed with very serious illnesses. And it, you know, it kind of opened me up more about expressing it, because I think it's important for us to know that there's more than what we just see here.
Absolutely.
And it, for me, it was a life changer. I changed so many things in my life, and, you know, some things I still need to work on. We all, that's why we're here. We
of course.
We need to work and learn.
Yes.
But, you know, I feel so grateful that I was able to go through that experience and then acknowledge and appreciate the journey that came, you know, following it. And it was so interesting, because one time I was on, this is how I got to the practices that I teach today. I was on a lot of different medications because I was having extreme anxiety and panic attacks. So they were testing different things with me, and I didn't feel like it was working. I was not somebody who liked to take medication.
Yes.
I, you know, felt like there had to be a natural way. And I was in my local pharmacy, and I saw this little sign of a woman that they were doing a fundraiser for. And this woman had been in a horse accident, where the horse reared up backwards. She fell over backwards with the horse on top of her, and she was paralyzed.
Oh,
okay,
my goodness.
Now, here I am walking still. I went through the same thing only months before.
Wow.
And, you know, I thought, this is something I have to acknowledge. And that's when I started speaking more on the spiritual side of what had happened to me, and came in touch with meditation, emotional freedom technique, you know, yoga. I really love yoga, mm-hmm. all of these different approaches.
Yes. Yeah. And Leah Marie, actually, listeners, is committed, as I know you can tell, to helping those who are looking to improve their well-being and is a holistic educator in the medical field training nurses, elder care providers, and social workers. Leah, how can my listeners learn more about your work?
Yeah, so I definitely have a website. It's mm-hmm. called mindhealthcoach.com. And I also can be contacted via email, so info@mindhealthcoach.com. But I have lots of articles and information on my blog page if anybody wants to learn more about the effects of meditation on the brain and overall well-being. I also have a CD that has daily meditation practices for 7 days of the week. So if you're, you know, kind of hesitant to start your daily practice to improve your brain health and overall well-being and not sure where to start, you can go on my website and order the MP3 version or the CD version.
Leah Marie, again, is a certified holistic life and stress management coach. She's my guest today during the lifestyle segment. Leah, I want to say, hats off to you, and there is an open invite when you'd like to come back to In the Know Radio Magazine Show.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that, Denise, and thank you for, you know, allowing me to come on. It's just a wonderful experience to share. And, you know, I hope I could help someone else.
I'm sure you did. Very vital information shared. Leah, thank you so much, and you have a blessed weekend.
Thank you. You too.
All right. Bye-bye. And again, listeners, that was Leah Marie. Information that was, you know, shared with us actually a near-death experience. I mean, she talked about that in-depthly. She talked about her journey to the other side as the most loving, peaceful, and eye-opening experience of her life. Wow. Fascinating information, natural ways to reduce stress, meditation and brain health, healing from near-death experience led her to natural ways to manage pain and PTSD, positive and inspirational.
I feel great, but here's the deal. The doctor just told me I have high blood pressure. And the kicker, the high blood pressure can lead to heart disease or a stroke or worse. So she said I need to lose weight, eat better, and exercise. And if that doesn't work, I may need to take medicine. I know I gotta fix this. For them.
Although you can feel perfectly healthy, you may still have high blood pressure. So get your blood pressure checked regularly. And if it's too high, talk to your doctor and make sure you understand your options. You may need to change the way you live. Your doctor may recommend medicine. To learn more about your options, go to ahrq.gov/consumer and select Comparing Medical Treatments. That's ahrq.gov/consumer. A message from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.
Hi, my name is Nikki, and I want to tell you about a great place where you can learn and grow, the Nashville Public Library. The library offers books, CDs, DVDs, playaways, and did you know you can download ebooks, audiobooks, and music straight from the library website? Library materials are free to anyone with a library card, and library cards can be obtained at any one of our 21 branches for every citizen at no charge. Nashville Public Library is more than just books. Visit the library website at library.nashville.org.
I feel like it's all on my shoulders. How am I going to take care of my parents if they develop an eye disease like glaucoma? Glaucoma is the leading cause of blindness in African Americans and Hispanics in the United States. And what about my kids? Will they inherit it? Not to mention my risk factor. I'm really concerned and I need some answers.
I'm Dr. Jeffrey Goldberg, an ophthalmologist and a scientist, supported by AHAF, the American Health Assistance Foundation. We're working to discover breakthrough treatments and a cure for glaucoma. At AHAF.org, we will answer your questions and address your concerns. Learn about glaucoma, its symptoms, risk factors, and treatment options. Also, how to live with or care for someone with the disease. Call 1-800-437-2423 or go to ahaf.org for a free brochure on how eye disease affects all our lives. That's 1-800-437-2423.
Thank you. kids and the itty-bitty kid in all of us. Host Auntie Bobbin uses multicultural songs and stories to encourage self-respect and understanding of different peoples. You'll hear rock, jazz, and folk that are grown-up friendly, like Nat King Cole, The Ramones, Alison Krauss, and Trout Fishing in America, all in the same hour. It's all on Turtle Radio, Mondays at 3, only on Radio Free Nashville.
Do you love great films? The Indie Film Minute is for you. Each week we bring you a selection of great films that you have likely never seen. Some, I assure you, you will have never heard of. The Indie Film Minute brings you reviews and recommendations of our favorites, all available for rental. Get ready for some great film experiences.
Hear the Indie Film Minute weekday mornings during RFN Early Brew on Radio Free Nashville.
Join host Jessica Carter for Friday Night Drama and let the sexiest voice in Nashville make you laugh, dance, and massage yourself with a speaker. Every Friday at 7 p.m., you'll hear local comics, actors, and musicians be inappropriate on the radio and find out what's going on around town. Tune in every Friday at 7 p.m. for all the drama on Friday Night Drama, pushing FCC rules and regulations to the limit since 2005.
Sit back, relax, and be rejuvenated on In the Know, the jazzy radio magazine show that keeps you in the know about entertainment, health, food, fashion, lifestyles, and community affairs. Join host Denise Barnes Fridays 9 to 10 a.m. on 103.7, 107.1 FM, WRFN.
And we are back, everyone. We are actually in our second hour of the show. It has been an exciting time. Again, thanks to my earlier guest, Leah Marie. And she talked to us about PTSD, stress, anxiety, all of that good stuff during the lifestyle segment. And at this time, beginning the second hour, again, you are listening to Radio Free Nashville 103.7 and 107.1 FM. And again, we are going to continue to keep the pages of the magazine turned to our lifestyle segment. And there is a new segment on the show regarding employment. Employment is very vital today, especially for our youth. And I'm going to let you hear an interview that I had with Ellen Zinkiewicz, and she is with the Nashville Career Advancement Center here in Davidson County, of course. And she works a lot and very closely with Mayor Megan Barry's initiative, Opportunity Now, to provide 10,000 opportunities for young people to work in the summer of 2017. So she was my guest earlier during the lifestyle segment, and she's going to talk a little bit more in-depthly about jobs for the youth and what they have coming up in the future. So again, you are listening to the lifestyle segment, and we're talking employment right here, and we will be right back with you.
We can talk to our peer cities. We can talk to other places where they've already been engaged in this work, maybe ahead of us, like in the case of summer youth employment.
Yes.
We had a lot of conversations with cities that ranged from San Francisco to Pittsburgh to other places that have been doing summer youth employment for a long time, mm-hmm. where Nashville is new to the game. And we were able to say, all right, if you had a friend who was asked by, say, a mayor to create a program that helped 10,000 young people, mm-hmm. what would you do? And we got a lot of really good feedback from other places because we had those connections, and the coalition really helps build those relationships so that those were easy phone calls. And again, it also, the coalition also helps support what's quality programming, mm-hmm. and keeps us focused on those young people who need the most support. So those young people who are really genuinely disconnected from work and disconnected from school, to help them get into the pipeline, into employment, get connected with the great opportunities that do exist in this city and in others, but that perhaps there's some skills that they need to get, either hard skills or what we often call soft skills, which are the parts about getting along with others and communication mm-hmm. that employers often talk about really wanting to see and struggling with workforce. I think the nice lady from CentOS talked about yes. you're the kind of person who wants to go above and beyond.
Absolutely.
And we can help young people identify what it is that they are passionate about, that they want to go above and beyond to do.
Absolutely.
And help connect them to the kinds of trainings and employment opportunities that will get them there. And we've really done our best to learn over the past, you know, 17 years mm-hmm. what works to help young people be successful as quickly as possible so that they are getting back into employment, into the training that they need, and moving into self-sufficient jobs.
Very important information, Ellen, because I always say our youth, they're our next generation, and it's very important, and I'm so proud and hats off to the mayor and for you and your organization for launching this program, Opportunity Now. Tell us more about that, Ellen.
Oh, I'm so excited about Opportunity Now.
Yes.
So, first of all, the mayor asked for three things. She wanted 10,000 opportunities for young people. She wanted those young people to be between the ages of 14 and 24, and she wanted every single one of those opportunities to be paid. Mm-hmm. So Nashville's Summer Youth Employment Program, the largest single internship program that we had last year, had 150 kids in it.
Wow.
So we're going from about 150 to 10,000.
Wow. Amazing.
And there's no single way to do that. So we've got a lot of different kinds of pieces because 10,000 is a lot of different people.
Yes, it is, Ellen. Yes, it is.
So we are working with one direct hire.
Okay.
So helping young people, I mean, young people often don't know that there are employers who would hire them.
That's right.
They don't know about a lot of different careers mm-hmm. that are out there. If they haven't seen it immediately in their world, they may not know that it exists.
Especially if they've never worked or just fresh out of school or college, right?
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely.
So they can see what's out there mm-hmm. and where those employers have said, yeah, I'll hire somebody under age 24, or sure, I don't really need 3 years of experience for you to start doing this job, because we both know, like, you know, the 18-year-old, the 22-year-old's lament, nobody will hire me because I don't have any experience. How am I supposed to get experience if nobody will hire me?
Yes.
Right? I mean,
right.
We've probably all said it.
Mm-hmm.
So we have employers who are saying, hey, I'm going to come to this one stop and bring my jobs. Because, yes, young people can do them. Yes, people without experience can do them. And I really want these workers to come to me. Mm-hmm. Now, some of those jobs are seasonal. They might be summer jobs.
Okay.
Some of them are year-round. Some of them are good on the weekends. Some of them are industries that are 24/7. So they would be great for our young people who are trying to go to college and go to work. Which many of our college students need part-time jobs.
Yes, they do.
So
yes.
We have a lot of those opportunities.
Okay.
Now, some of those opportunities are the kinds of places where you could build a career in that field.
Mm-hmm.
Others are that place that you need while you're doing a job, while you're getting your degree or while you're getting your diploma. Mm-hmm. And when you're done with getting your degree and getting your diploma, you're going to go off to do something completely different.
Yes, yes.
You learn to work by working. And very often, and increasingly studies kind of show, the younger you start working, the more likely you are to maintain an employment for longer.
And that is so true. Yes, it is.
And also, believe it or not, to earn higher wages going forward.
Starting early.
Exactly.
Starting early.
So starting early is kind of the magic.
Yes, ma'am.
But so we've got this direct hire piece, and mm-hmm. we're really excited about that. That's a lot of our jobs.
Okay.
We also have some positions that were created really just for Opportunity Now.
Okay.
So those include what we call experience work for 14 and 15-year-olds. Some 16, 17-year-olds can apply, but those are project-based initiatives where young people are going to work as part of a team to implement a project.
Okay.
And at the end of the summer, they'll be able to say, hey, look what I did. Mm-hmm. But the most important thing they're going to get out of it is practice working with a group of people. Practice with communicating, practice with showing up every day.
Yes.
And they absolutely will be paid for what they're doing.
And they have to take on that responsibility, Ellen. And that's a mature factor for them as well at an early age.
Absolutely.
Very important.
And I can't promise everybody on your team is going to be that person that is your favorite person to work with. Because I think we all know in the real world, not everybody that you work with is your favorite person.
That's right.
There's a skill that you learn in the workplace around navigating all kinds of people. So we're giving them a chance to practice that. We also have a program we call a high school internship program.
Okay.
And those are, they're also time limited. It's just for the summer. It's also paid.
Okay.
And it is a career exploration opportunity. So you'd be placed at, or get to, you can apply for locations that range from R.C. Matthews and Stansel Electric to the mayor's office.
Okay.
If you want an internship at the mayor's office this year, you have to apply through Opportunity Now.
Oh, and you're going to get them to apply with that.
Please do.
Absolutely, yes.
So we have opportunities for young people within that high school internship program. So when you're the entry-level worker, you're often out there, you're doing the company's business.
That's right.
But when you are the person who's in the corporate office, you're not only learning the company's business, you're also learning the other jobs that exist to make that industry successful. The accounting, the marketing, the HR functions.
All aspects of the company.
The IT, exactly. The kinds of things that are mysterious or secret or hidden if sometimes you're that entry-level worker.
Wow.
So this is a time-limited opportunity for them to really see what it means to be in the corporate office.
Right, in the nerve of it.
Exactly.
So yes, very interesting information. Again, Ellen, you're responsible for Nashville Career Advancement Center's youth programs. One other question I have for you. Now, the mayor actually launched Opportunity Now job portal at Pearl Cone. Tell us about that.
Oh, I love Pearl Cone. It's one of my favorite places in the city.
Yes.
And those young people on Friday were so great.
Oh,
we
wow.
were so glad to be there. Mm-hmm. They do such amazing things, and we were glad to let them shine. The portal is live at the on.nashville.gov landing page, or you can just go to nashville.gov and follow the links to the Opportunity Now page, and there's a portal link right there. Now, it will only let you explore those jobs if you're a Davidson County resident and or going to be in Davidson County for the summer, or if you are 24 or under.
Okay.
So for any of your listeners who are wondering, hey, where can I go to find other jobs? It will also tell you, if you come in and you're older than that, it will link you to other resources such as jobsfortn.gov, webuildtech.com, so other places you can go and look for jobs as grown-ups.
Wow.
But Opportunity Now is just for young people.
And it's just what the young people need, Ellen, because it was actually launched by the mayor to help curb youth violence. Tell us more about the Youth Violence Summit.
So, I was able to be part of one element of the Youth Violence Summit, and I was very excited that the mayor kicked off this initiative by asking young people, not standing around and telling young people what was right and what was wrong, but genuinely asking them, all right, what do you need?
Yes.
Now, they responded with some of what also makes sense to us, especially people who are in workforce development.
Mm-hmm.
What does a job give you?
Yes.
Well, it takes up a lot of time. And it provides financial resources. You work, you get paid. So when you have young people who maybe have a little too much time on their hands or not enough community-based options and things that they can be engaged in that are positive, a job can really fill that vacuum and help provide additional structure, take their time, provide some added purpose, and a little bit of money in your pocket.
That's
never
right.
goes astray. So one of the things we found when we implemented the ARRA in 2009, the stimulus package, we did summer youth employment that summer for 1,100 young people. And one of the things we found was that our young people don't have long-term savings goals or long-term things they want to do with their money the way that we as grown-ups think. Like, they're not thinking retirement. Even when they're thinking long-term goals, like, I'm going to save for a car in 18 months. I'm going to save for going to college in 2 years. But very often it was, my family needs this additional resource to come in to help pay these bills. It would help my mama if I was working and could pay for my own clothes and my own school pieces. Yes. Young people really want to contribute. They want to contribute to our larger community.
They absolutely do.
They want to contribute to their families and for to provide that additional support so that they can help their family and be part of that team.
Yes. And feel and valued.
Exactly.
Young people need to feel valued by everyone and taking the initiative and no longer idle hands, because idle hands, of course, and idle minds does not lead to anything positive. So again, the Mayor's Office and Nashville Career Advancement Center, hats off to you for launching this initiative, Opportunity Now. And Ellen, if there are any, there are people out there who are seeking available job opportunities, how can you help?
So if you're a Davidson County resident or you're going to be in Davidson County this summer, age 24 and under, you can go to on.nashville.gov, click on the link, and use the Opportunity Now portal. If you're older than that, or perhaps you live just outside of Davidson County, jobs4tn.gov is a great resource full of jobs that are available in this area. And then, of course, I'm totally impressed with the employers that you've got on your show, this is great networking opportunity here and learning what's open and available. But we, the American Job Center, is also always a good first door to knock on, and it's right here in Metro Center in Davidson County.
Sounds good, Ellen. And is there any information that they can contact you yourself, or do they go through the Career
Opportunity
Center?
Now at nashville.gov is the best place to go with specific questions. We're always answering those questions through when they come through that email.
Sounds good. Again, Ellen, thank you so much. We will definitely be in touch, and hopefully we can work with you to help get jobs out there to our youth and others as well.
Really appreciate it.
There's
thank
an
you
open
so
invite
much.
For you to come back to Employment Talk today.
Looking forward to it.
Thank you. And again, I hope you enjoyed that interview with Ellen, Ellen Zinkiewicz, and she is with the Nashville Career Advancement Center in Davidson County. And again, she has over 19 years experience in the field of workforce development, and they are working hand in hand with Mayor Megan Barry's initiative, Opportunity Now, as I mentioned, to provide 10,000 opportunities for young people to work in the summer of 2017. Again, my brand new segment here, Employment Talk Today, during the show. Program providers will be offering the following services through the Career Center. Every young person will not receive every service, but based on an individualized assessment, it will be determined which services are applicable for each individual. Now, here are just a few: tutoring, study skills and activities leading to dropout prevention, alternative secondary school offerings, summer employment linked directly to academic and occupational learning, paid and unpaid work experiences, occupational skills training, leadership development opportunities, supportive services, adult mentoring, follow-up services, and comprehensive guidance and counseling as appropriate. Again, the new segment here, Employment Talk Today, and it's also a part of our community affairs segment, because we're reaching out in the community as we love to do and we are known for here at Radio Free Nashville. So again, continue to stay in the know. Go on my public figure pages, like my page on Facebook, and that is In the Know Radio Magazine Show. Follow me on Twitter at ITK Radio Mag Show to learn more about the show and the various segments.
It's our 12th year, so we are seniors, and that means we're having a senior prom. Join us at Radio Free Nashville's Birthday Bash Senior Prom. This is on Sunday, April the 2nd from 1 to 4 p.m. at Yazoo Brew. It'll be better than the prom you had in high school. Trust me, we've got music from Easy Roscoe, Screaming Names, MD, and Cobalt Blue, and also lots of goodies and fun, including Nothing But Cake, Mike's Ice Cream, a dance contest, great prizes, and delicious, and I say delicious, Yazoo Brew. And with your ticket purchase, four are included. Advance tickets are on sale now. Contact myself, or you can go through eventbrite.com. And by the way, we'll be crowning a prom king and queen. Yes, I said it. We will be crowning a prom king and queen. And if you want to vie for that crown, dress to impress. Our 12th birthday party, the senior prom. Make sure that you come out and have fun with us. You're listening to another edition of In the Know, the Jazzy Radio Magazine Show, and we'll be right back with you.
Thank you. Hello, boys and girls. I'll reach into the magic castle and bring that tree in my hand. Just sit back, relax, rest in the safety belts.
Turtle Radio is for big kids and the itty-bitty kid in all of us. Host Auntie Bobbin uses multicultural songs and stories to encourage self-respect and understanding of different peoples. You'll hear rock, jazz, and folk that are grown-up friendly, like Nat King Cole, The Ramones, Alison Krauss, and Trout Fishing in America, all in the same hour. It's all on Turtle Radio Mondays at 3, only on Radio Free Nashville.
Do you love great films? The Indie Film Minute is for you. Each week we bring you a selection of great films that you have likely never seen. Some, I assure you, you will have never heard of. The Indie Film Minute brings you reviews and recommendations of our favorites, all available for rental. Get ready for some great film experiences.
Hear the Indie Film Minute, weekday mornings during RFN Early Brew on Radio Free Nashville.
Join host Jessica Carter for Friday Night Drama and let the sexiest voice in Nashville make you laugh, dance, and massage yourself with a speaker. Every Friday at 7 p.m., you'll hear local comics, actors, and musicians be inappropriate on the radio and find out what's going on around town. Tune in every Friday at 7 p.m. for all the drama on Friday Night Drama, pushing FCC rules and regulations to the limit since 2005.
Hi, I'm Jonathan. I'm a big supporter of Radio Free Nashville. Tune in daily at 2 p.m. for Democracy Now!, the national daily independent award-winning news program hosted by journalist Amy Goodman and Juan Gonzalez. Democracy Now! Provides access to people and perspectives rarely heard in the U.S. corporate-sponsored media, including independent and international journalists. Ordinary people from around the world who are directly affected by U.S. foreign policy, grassroots leaders and peace activists, artists, academics, and independent analysts. Hear the real debate weekdays at 2 on Democracy Now!, right here on Radio Free Nashville.
Nashville, you're listening to WRFN Radio Free Nashville. This is Will with Phenomenal Advice. Check me out every Thursday evening from 5 o'clock to 6 o'clock as I give you the latest health and fitness pointers and tips to transfer your life into a healthy one. Everyone take care and peace.
I don't eat no meat, no dairy, no sweets. Only ripe vegetables, fresh fruit and whole wheat. I'm from the old school. My household smell like soul food, bruh. Curry falafel, barbecue tofu. No
hey, all y'all blues children out there. Y'all tune in to Have Blues Will Travel, Thursday nights, 8 to 9, on Radio Free Nashville. Gonna give you that good down-home blues, y'all.
Like a wide range of music? Then tune in to the Haggard and Haggard Radio Hour, a fixture on Radio Free Nashville since 2008. Host Steve Haggard plays an eclectic mix of music of many styles and many eras. Americana, blues, rock, folk, rockabilly, old standards, indie music, songs in other languages, plus a lot of meaningless less banter. The Haggard and Haggard Radio Hour, Tuesdays at 4 on Radio Free Nashville.
And we are back again, everyone. I hope you are enjoying another edition of In the Know, the Jazzy Radio Magazine show. And at this time, we are turning the pages back to our entertainment segment for In the Know's Jazzy Top 10 Countdowns for the week. Coming in at number 10 is Wonderland, Brian Simpson. Number 9, So Cool, Doc Powell featuring Melvin Jones. Number 8, Do I Do, Peter White. Number 7, Tuesday Swings, Jazz Funk Soul. Number 6, coming in, is I Want You Girl, BWB. Number 5, Why Not, Marc Antoine featuring Felipe Sassi. Number 4, Category A, Cindy Bradley featuring Chris Standring. Coming in at number 3, I Am, and that's Kayla Waters featuring Kim Waters. Coming in at number 2 is Joyride, Adam Hawley. And making the top 10 list for this week, Morning Call with Nick Colleone.
Thank you.
Your flavor. That's a really, really, you know, tasty one to lead into my next segment, which is the food segment. Again, you are tuned into another edition of In the Know, the jazzy radio magazine show that keeps you in the know about entertainment, health, food, fashion, lifestyles, and community affairs. I am your host, Denise Barnes, right here with you. And at this time, we are turning the pages of the magazine to our food segment. These are 10 foods that actually affect your risk of heart disease the most. Just 10 foods account for nearly half of all heart disease deaths in the U.S. If people ate less salt and meat and ate more nuts, fruits, and vegetables, they could greatly lower their own risk of heart disease. This from researchers at Tufts Friedman School of Nutrition, Science, and Policy. Now, again, it comes together in a handy list of what to eat more of and what to eat less of. You want to eat more of nuts, seafood rich in omega-3 fatty acids, vegetables, fruits, whole grains, polyunsaturated fats such as soybean oil, corn oil, walnuts, and flaxseed oil. These are what you want to eat less of, listeners. Sodium, processed meats, sugar-sweetened beverages, red meat such as steak or pork chops. Now, Renata Micha of Tufts and colleagues developed their list from national surveys covering 16,000 people from 1999 through 2012. Volunteers filled out food diaries in real time and were followed for years after to see what happened to their health. Now, in 2012, Mika's team wrote, more than 700,000 Americans died of heart disease, estimated 45% due to heart disease, stroke, and type 2 diabetes. Now, these were associated with suboptimal intakes of the 10 dietary factors. And they use published studies on the benefits or drawbacks of each of the 10 foods to figure out just how much each one contributes to the risk of death from heart disease. By their calculations, eating too much sodium, and that's more than 2,000 milligrams a day, accounted for 9.5% of those deaths. Eating too few nuts, less than about half a handful a day, accounted for 8.5% of the deaths. Eating too much processed meat accounted for 8.2% of the deaths. Eating too little seafood was responsible for 7.8% of those deaths. So again, just a little information during my food segment, and you can also attribute this to the health segment as well. 10 foods affect your risk of heart disease the most.
I feel great, but here's the deal. The doctor just told me I have high blood pressure. And the kicker, the high blood pressure can lead to heart disease or stroke or worse. So she said I need to lose weight, eat better, and exercise. And if that doesn't work, I may need to take medicine. I know I gotta fix this.
Turtle Radio is for big kids and the itty-bitty kid in all of us. Host Auntie Bobbin uses multicultural songs and stories to encourage self-respect and understanding of different peoples. You'll hear rock, jazz, and folk that are grown-up friendly, like Nat King Cole, The Ramones, Alison Krauss, and Trout Fishing in America, all in the same hour. It's all on Turtle Radio Mondays at 3, only on Radio Free Nashville.
Do you love great films? The Indie Film Minute is for you. Each week we bring you a selection of great films that you have likely never seen. Some, I assure you, you will have never heard of. The Indie Film Minute brings you reviews and recommendations of our favorites, all available for rental. Get ready for some great film experiences.
Hear the Indie Film Minute, weekday mornings during RFN Early Brew on Radio Free Nashville.
Join host Jessica Carter for Friday Night Drama and let the sexiest voice in Nashville make you laugh, dance, and massage yourself with a speaker. Every Friday at 7 p.m., you'll hear local comics, actors, and musicians be inappropriate on the radio and find out what's going on around town. Tune in every Friday at 7 p.m. for all the drama on Friday Night Drama, pushing FCC rules and regulations to the limit since 2005.
Sit back, relax, and be rejuvenated on In the Know, the jazzy radio magazine show that keeps you in the know about entertainment, health, food, fashion, lifestyles, and community affairs. Join host Denise Barnes Fridays 9 to 10 a.m. on 103.7, 107.1 FM, WRFN.
Turtle Radio is for big kids and the itty-bitty kid in all of us. Host Auntie Bobbin uses multicultural songs and stories to encourage self-respect and understanding of different peoples. You'll hear rock, jazz, and folk that are grown-up friendly, like Nat King Cole, The Ramones, Alison Krauss, and Trout Fishing in America, all in the same hour. It's all on Turtle Radio Mondays at 3, only on Radio Free Nashville.
We are back again, everyone, and you are listening to another edition of In the Know, radio magazine show. And at this time, we're turning the pages of the magazine to our community affairs segment. President Trump is scheduled to visit Nashville, Tennessee. And here's a statement from Mayor Megan Barry on his visit on this Wednesday. Mayor Megan Barry is aware that President Trump intends to visit Nashville on Wednesday, March 15th. Now, the mayor's office has not received any guidance or details from the White House about President Trump's visit as of yet. But Metro will work with the White House and Secret Service to ensure that the president's visit is safe and any impact on traffic or accessibility to government services is as minimal as possible. And here is part of Mayor Barry's statement on the president's upcoming visit. Nashville is a warm and welcoming city for all, and that certainly includes President Trump and his supporters who will be attending this event. I hope that during President Trump's visit to Nashville, he has an opportunity to experience our diverse culture and welcoming values that make our city and our economy so successful. Mayor Barry goes on to say, if we have the chance to meet, I would love to follow up on our previous phone conversation about Nashville's desire to be included in the president's plan for improving infrastructure across the nation. The mayor's office cannot comment on details of the president's visit until further guidance is received from the White House.
Thank you.
Hey, we have had a fabulous show today, and I hope that you have enjoyed it. I want you to continue to keep it here on Radio Free Nashville. I am your host, Denise Barnes, in the Know Radio Magazine Show, with a jazzy radio magazine show that keeps you in the know about entertainment, health, food, fashion, lifestyles, and community affairs. And remember, connect with me on social media, Facebook, the public figure page is In the Know Radio Magazine Show. And on Twitter, feel free to follow me at ITK Radio Mag Show. Again, thanks to my earlier guest, Leah Marie, with her fabulous information. My entertainment reporter on the West Coast in Las Vegas, Stephen Littles. Make sure that you stay connected with us as we are at RadioFreeNashville.org. Again, we have had a fabulous show, everyone. And thanks again. And remember, if it's in the news, it's on In the Know Radio Magazine Show.